Hi everybody, hola a todos, esta es Andrea. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my experience about what happened when I stopped playing my harp for 3 months. Why I did that and what happened after I came back to the harp. Entonces amigos, hoy les voy a conversar, a compartir mi experiencia de qué pasó cuando dejé de tocar mi arpa por más de 3 meses, el por qué dejé de tocarla y qué pasó después que regresé a tocar el arpa por ese tiempo. ¿Qué pasó? Okay, I don't want to say that it's bad news. It's actually, it has a lot of good news in it. No quiero decir que fue malas noticias, más bien tiene muchas cosas buenas, muchas noticias buenas, muchas experiencias buenas. I learned a lot out of this experience. Aprendí mucho de esta experiencia and I think I'm still learning. Creo que sigo aprendiendo. Okay, so the story goes like this. Así va la historia. And remember, this is a bilingual video, so be patient, sé paciente. Este video es bilingüe y toma un poquito más de tiempo por la traducción, because I need to translate myself. Excuse me. Okay. La historia va así. And the story goes like this. I got sick at the end of February. Me enfermé al final de febrero. And I said at the end. Okay. So let's say a week before the end. I don't know. And I pretty much play for most of the month. But after, I'm going to say April, and then March, and then May, I didn't play. And when I say I didn't play, you know, maybe I touched the harp. Maybe I did a few things, but it does not really play. Entonces yo dejé de tocar, tal vez toqué casi todo febrero, pero tal vez la última semana no estaba tocando. Pero no lo contaré por ahora. Vamos a contar una semana tal vez que de febrero. Pero abril, marzo y mayo no toqué. Y tal vez la primera semana de junio. Also probably the first week of June I didn't really play. So that's why I said for more than 3 months, probably 3 months and a half, I stopped playing. And so what happened was that I got sick at the end of February. And me enfermé al final del mes de febrero. I got a terrible cold that I really thought it was the flu. Tuve un resfrío horrible que pensé que era la influenza. y I didn't go to the doctor right away. I thought that it was just a cold. And, you know, I went to the doctor after, like, the fourth day that I was feeling like, Fui al doctor después de tal vez 4 días que ya me sentía mal, porque al principio pensé que era un resfrío y pasaría rápido. But no, so they said, I felt like it was the flu. I'm like, I really think I need something. At least I need to know what it is. And they said, it's a cold. And I said, like, are you sure it's a cold? I really think it's the flu. And I'm like, no. But, you know, it's still bad. But I'm happy that the doctor did say, I'm happy it's not the flu, though. Yo pensé que era la influencia. Dije, ¿de verdad que no es la influencia? Porque me siento como que... Dice, no, pero me alegro que no sea. Okay. And then that week, the same week that I got sick, I discovered something very important. And that's why I said it's very good, actually, that I didn't, it wasn't the flu. Y esa semana que me enfermé de este resfrío, en realidad descubrí algo muy importante. Y por eso digo que es bueno, es de verdad muy bueno que no fue la influenza. So, I discovered, I'll show you guys, I'll show you, that I was expecting a baby. My third baby, my third child. Descubrí que estaba embarazada y esperando mi tercer hijo, mi bebé. So, it was ex- I mean, it still is, of course. It was very exciting to learn that I was expecting a baby. Fue muy, muy emocionante saber que estaba esperando un bebé, pero a pesar de eso, no me sentía bien. So it was exciting, but even though it was exciting for all of us, I wasn't feeling well, so it was hard to enjoy the news. So after that, I mean, I had that cold for like for maybe 2 weeks and a half. I tuve ese resfrío por lo menos 2 semanas. Fue terrible. It was hard. It was terrible. So after that, some of the symptoms went away. I'm sorry, it's just I talk too much. Algunos de los síntomas se fueron, pero no todos. Y digo no todos porque tuve síntomas de embarazo del primer trimestre. So I said not all the symptoms left, and because of the symptoms, some of them were similar. But they got worse, actually, because I had morning sickness for my first trimester, and it actually lasted more than 3 months, like 3.5. So it's pretty much the time I stopped playing. Es básicamente el tiempo que paré de tocar, el tiempo que me duró los síntomas del primer trimestre, que fue más de como casi 3 meses y medio. Okay, so I had a lot of fatigue, I had nausea, I was vomiting. Tenía fatiga, tenía náuseas, tenía vómito. I didn't really vomit every day, but I was nauseous the whole day, every single day of those 3.5 months. Y no vomité por todos los días, pero me sentía con náuseas todos los días. Todo el tiempo. I had fatigue. I didn't have energy for anything. No tenía energía para nada con la fatiga. Y me dolía el cuerpo. Tenía solo cansancio. I was so tired. That couch over there was my best friend. And she's still my best friend. Todavía es mi mejor amigo. Ese sofá de atrás. Bueno. Vamos a seguir con la historia. Después de todo ese tiempo que me sentí así, mi esposo no sé qué tanto pensó que me lo inventé. pero I maybe my husband thought I you know, I made it up, but it was real, okay? And I still had to keep up with everything that I had to do for my kids. Y todavía tenía que hacer todo lo que tenía que hacer por mis hijos. And fue bien difícil, pero I stopped my harp lessons pretty much when the first month after I learned that I was expecting because the way I felt. And actually before, because I got sick, so I stopped. And then I didn't go back. No regresé a las, después que me enfermé de eso, no regresé a las clases de arpa. But my children, they continued taking their harp lessons, and that was also that was a different day, and they kept on playing. So my harp teacher, she encouraged me to continue at least practicing for 5 minutes, you know, whenever I had time or I felt with some energy practicing chords, so I wouldn't, you know, forget to move my fingers. And you know, so I did. Yo mi maestra me dio ánimos para que por lo menos 5 minutos cuando pueda, 1 o 2 veces a la semana, continúe practicando por lo menos los acordes, y eso me ayudó. So after my kids' lesson, I probably practiced with her for 10 minutes or a little less. Después de la clase de mis hijos, yo practiqué con ellos, tal vez con ella, mi maestra, por unos 5 o 10 minutos. Entonces eso me ayudó. So that really helped, even though I kind of, you know, lost a lot. So that's what happened in that first part of my story, my experience. And that was why. Por eso, esa es la parte de qué pasó y el por qué. So at probably this month, June, I came back to my harp And I did practice maybe before. I have to say that I didn't complete, you know, stop playing, like not touching the harp. But I played like once a week, 5 minutes or less. I just lost my passion. Yo tocaba tal vez una vez a la semana por menos de 5 minutos. Tocaba los acordes. Pero yo simplemente no podía tocar porque perdí la pasión. So I really pray and I ask God, please put it back, put back my passion. Even though after I stopped, the, you know, the morning sickness kind of got better or went away, I just did not have the passion. I didn't have the interest. No tenía ni la energía, ni la pasión, la perdí. Yo le pedí a Dios que por favor me la regrese porque yo la extrañaba. I missed it and I just couldn't play. And even the practicing with my kids, which is already not that easy because they always want to play and in the house, jump, watch TV or do whatever. So it's hard to have kids play instruments, to just practice, you know, even though they like to play. Era difícil que sentarme con ellos. It was hard just to sit with my kids, con mis hijos, a que ellos practiquen. Porque los niños de por sí se distraen, quieren hacer otras cosas y practicar su instrumento no es algo que les llama la atención, la práctica. Entonces no es fácil, pero para mí fue difícil porque I didn't even listen to music. I don't want to do anything. I think my ear got very sensitive and just it was too much in general. Yo creo que mi oído era muy sensible y no escuchaba ni música ni veía nada. Bueno, entonces cuando regresé, que fue este mes, tal vez la segunda semana, la primera al final, ¿verdad? Comencé a regresar a mis canciones. Descubrí que solo podía tocar dos. Sublime Gracia y Brian Brew. So after I came back, maybe at the end of the first week of June, I discovered that I could only play two songs, Amazing Grace and Brian Brew. And it's interesting because Brian Brew was the first song that I learned when I started playing harp. Esa es la, Brian Brew fue la primera canción que comencé a tocar cuando, harp lessons, cuando comencé a tomar clases de arpa. I guess it has to do with something with, you know, it was the first song that I really got in my head and my fingers. Creo que tiene que ver con cómo el cerebro recuerda la primera canción en los dedos y en el mismo de memoria. Así que eso es algo interesante. So that was very interesting to notice. Out of like 35, I'm going to throw a number like that, como de 35 canciones por decir que tengo, que me sé. Not necessarily big songs, long songs, or fancy ones. No necesariamente grandes canciones, o tú sabes. Tal vez solo eran dos. Que me acordé, fue tan frustrante, it was so frustrating. My fingers forgot, even like the song in my ears. Me olvidé hasta la canción en el ritmo. Era difícil, terrible, frustrante. But after like 2 weeks, like putting time into it, I think I got maybe 5-6 songs. But it's only 2 weeks, so I'm happy because they are coming back to my fingers. Tal vez tengo 5 canciones, ya han regresado 6. Y I have to say that yesterday and the day before, but especially yesterday, I sat down for maybe more than 2 hours. Me senté tal vez ayer y antes de ayer, sobre todo ayer, por más de 2 horas, y I was able to remember maybe like yesterday I got like 3 songs back in 1 day, but I put like 3 hours. Ayer recuperé como 3 canciones, pero puse como 3 horas. Now, when I said I got them back, it doesn't mean that they are perfect. I mean, like, I got them. They need practice. So I decided not to learn new songs. Decidí no aprender más canciones because my goal right now is to remember the ones that I forgot. And I forgot them here, and I forgot them here. But I noticed that my fingers get it, you know, the song comes back to my fingers than to my mind. I don't know, it's very interesting. Muscle memory, it's very interesting. Las canciones regresan más rápido a mis dedos que a mi mente, y es interesante porque siempre se habla de la memoria de los músculos, de los dedos o de los músculos en general del cuerpo. Pero es verdad, it's bien interesante. Also, I've been learning and I'm still learning a lot of out of this experience. And I'm very happy because I'm expecting my baby. And this is my third child. Estoy bien contenta, este es mi tercer bebé. Y con tres, ya sería mi tercer hijo. Suena como que mucho. Sounds like a lot, but that's how it is. And I'm happy. Something very fun and sweet that when I sit down and, you know, the baby moves already. I can feel, I mean, he's been moving for a long time, but I now I can feel the baby pretty much moving. And a lot. And every time I start playing, and he's usually not moving at that moment. And then, but when I start playing, I don't know if he wakes up or he likes to, I hope he does, because he has no other choice. No creo que tiene, no tiene otra opción. Así que yo creo que le gusta el arpa. Él se comienza a mover cuando escucha el arpa. No sé si se despierta o es de emoción, pero bueno, no hay otra opción, así que I'm expecting a new harpist. Yes, I am. He doesn't have another option. I say he because he's a boy. Okay, no tiene otra opción. Estoy esperando un nuevo artista y así es la vida, nuestra vida. Okay, I'm gonna continue working hard on this. Voy a continuar a trabajar fuerte en esto. And I'll probably give you an update, I don't know when, but you know, I'm also behind the perfect song, the cover. Estoy atrasada con el cover de Ed Sheeran, de Perfect. I don't know what I'm gonna do that, but I'll do it. I mean, that's one of the songs that came back, so like it's pretty much back, but it's not ready for a cover. Ya la regresó a mí, pero no está lista para un cover. Pero en algún momento, ¿ok? So, I love you guys. Los quiero. I'll see you around. I'll see you around, ¿ok? Los veo. I love you. And stay safe. I love you. ¡Mua!